Father, why do we stand when the gospel is proclaimed?
Hello, I'm Father Finn. Thank you for joining us on this edition of the Wonders of the Mass. If you've been following along with us on this series of the Wonders of the Mass, we have been exploring the Liturgy of the Word. This week, we're going to take a deeper dive into the Gospel reading and its posture. When the sacred scriptures are read in the church, God Himself speaks to His people, and in the Gospel reading, Christ, present in His own Word, proclaims the Gospel. This is the high point of the Liturgy of the Word, when the priest proclaims the Gospel. You will notice that the posture during the Gospel reading is that the faithful are standing. We stand as a sign of respect when greeting Christ to anticipate the proclamation of the good news. The word gospel comes from the Latin evangelion, which means good news. In the gospels, we hear about the words and deeds of Jesus Christ himself. The gospel receives several special signs of honor and reverence because it speaks about the life, the ministry, and the preaching of Jesus Christ. First, we see at the beginning of the Mass, in the entrance procession, the book of the Gospels is carried in with honor, then placed on the altar until the time for the Gospel reading. It is here it represents the unity of Scripture and the Eucharist, of the Gospel of the Word of God, and the table of the Body and Blood of Christ. And after the second reading, the book of the Gospels is taken in procession towards the ambo, accompanied by an acclamation sung by the people. Another special sign that shows the significance of the gospel is that it is proclaimed by an ordained minister, sometimes a deacon, or, when no deacon is present, by a priest, who is in the person of Christ for us during the Mass. The priest will also kiss the gospel book after the reading as a sign of reverence. An awareness of the special reverence and honor that we have for the readings helps us to be more focused in this good news. Practice good listening skills so that God can penetrate your heart and let you hear the words that He has particularly for you in this Mass, in this time. I'm sure that God has a very special message for you in this Mass, so be attentive and listen. Thank you for joining us on this segment of the Mass. Join us again next week. And remember, when you leave the Mass, live the Mass.